वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वति नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणि विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थाविव संपृक्तौ वागर्थप्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरौ वन्दे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ धातु ब्रह्मैव संप्रोक्तो जीव आख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृति कृत्सुबंतादिर धातु ब्रह्मात्मने नमः। सो वी लुक एट दी तिंगंत प्रत्ययस सॉरी तिंग विच आर फॉर परस्मै पदम एंड आत्मने पदम धातुज विच टेक परस्मै पदम प्रत्ययस आर परस्मै पदी धातुज एंड धातुज विच टेक आत्मने पदम प्रत्ययस आर आत्मने पदी धातुज those who can take both pratyas, both types of pratyas, those dhatus are called as ubhayapadi dhatus. Then we looked at kartari prayoga and kartari prayoga, the karta, we saw the karakas, there are six karaka vibhaktis in the subanta pada and we saw the meaning of each of the karakas and then we saw that the sixth vibhakti, shashti vibhakti is a sambandha vibhakti. That is where we were and we looked at all the declensions of Rama Shabda. Sorry, so Rama Shabda we saw. Now before we, this is the this is the declension we saw for Tinganta. He is what the meanings are: singular, dual, plural, and Prathama Purusha, Madhyama Purusha, and Uttama Purusha, which is first person. Then in Subanta, before we go to Subanta, I just mentioned 10 ganas. So let me also mention the ganas, which are the ganas, the names of the ganas, and what is the vikarana, what is the change that takes place before you go to Sub. I would like to talk about ganas and how to identify the gana, chance of the gana being identified, which gana would the declension belong to, and this is specifically in Lat Lakara, and there are the three lakaras also which can be identified where you see these kind of changes in the anga, the body to which this tip pratyaya is added. These are the 10 ganas. So we say first gana, second gana, third gana, that way, but the name of the gana is, first gana is Vadi gana. Vadi gana, bhu is the dhatu. So bhu and adi sandhi vadi gana. Now we look at what this means a little later, guna, but it's a modification of an anga where the letter, the last letter or last vowel of the dhatu can take a change, a little change, as in u becoming o or e becoming a, that kind of a change, that is called as guna. We'll see guna a little later, but the pratyaya which is added to the dhatu, that is a, for the first gana. Technically it is something else with the packaging. This is after the packaging being removed. The vadi gana vikarna pratyaya, gana vikarna pratyaya is a. The adadi gana, this is the second gana. Second gana is called adadi gana and third gana is called jyotyadi gana. For all these three ganas, the vikarna pratyaya is a. But only in the first gana, vadi gana, the akara remains, this a remains. But in the adadi gana, it goes. It goes by a technical process by which a goes here in second gana and in third gana, they are different. The way in which akara is removed, the akara is removed for adadi gana is different from the way the akara is removed for the third gana, jyotyadi gana. Therefore, the akara being there, although it is gone, since it has come and gone, it can make all the changes that it can cause in the first gana. For example, here it is written guna on anga, on the dhatu, it can cause guna, as in the dhatu is ending in ukara or ikara, for example, the ukara can become ekara, the ukara can become okara, these kind of the changes can happen or in the dhatu, dhatu's last letter. This is what a causes in the first gana. This is technically what is called as shab. With the packaging letter, it will be called shab. So adadi gana, when it goes, this if the dhatu ends in a vowel which can take a guna, then it can cause a guna, because the presence of akara is felt in the second gana, although it is not there. So in the when you add the form, when you add, that time guna may or may not occur, but the akara will not be there when you make the sandhi, when you put the dhatu and the tip pratyaya together. But akara will be there in vadi gana. It can cause guna also, and the akara will be seen, like bhu plus a will be bho, and bho plus a will be bhav, and bhav plus a will be bhava. So akara is there in the first gana, then bhava plus ti will be bhavati. But in adadi gana, let's say the adadi gana, because the first dhatu in adadi gana is at, at dhatu, and at plus a will become adadi. At fo- not at plus a actually, at followed by akara, as in followed by an ending. At is a ending, and thereby at will become ad. Dakara it will become. We'll see sandhi a little later. But adadi is that which, that gana, that group which has at as a dhatu in its beginning. The first dhatu is at. Similarly, jyotyadi, jyoti is the first dhatu. Actually, dhatu is who, and who becomes juhoti because there is a reduplication in the third gana, because the manner in which akara is elided in the third gana, that causes reduplication of the dhatu. The who will become who, and who can, ukara can take guna and become ho, but who will become huho, and huho, the who will become ju. All that is not important. I'm just mentioning as to how to identify a dhatu. This who, if you see something like who, and this jakara is a change, we'll see what jakara means here, that hakara in a particular situation will become jakara, and that jakara, because of jakara, this jakara is of the dhatu hu only. So it is having become ju, it is still ju hu. The hu dhatu itself has become hu and juhu, and the ukara in the end has taken a guna, which is ukara has become okara. So juho, juho and tip is added at the end, so that tip is juhoti, juhoti plus adi, juhotyadi, that is the third gana. Wherever you see a duplication, something like a duplication, we'll see how to identify a duplication possibly, what has happened in the, a little later, thereby we'll be able to identify a gana. If there is a duplication in the dhatu and some change in the first replica. First replica of the dhatu, what is called as jashtvam. If jash has happened, then we will be able to see that, make out that this is the third gana. There is an importance why to identify dhatu, which gana is important, or what kind of changes if you are yourself declining it. So that is reduplication in the third gana, and that reduplication is because the way in which akara is elided, akara content is not there. So this adadi gana, akara content is not there, but it does not cause reduplication. And at plus ti will be atti. Just putting them together, because akara is not there, it will not become atati, it will become atti. At double takara, at and tip takara, atti. In juhotyadi, just juho and ti put together, because o is the guna, but akara has been elided, there is no other change. It is not going to become like here, vadi gana, bho was there, and bho had become bho, and bho plus a sandhi would have been bhav. That bhav here, if akara had been there, it would have been juho. Juho would have become va, av, it would have become av, and you would have gotten juhav. Juhav it has not become, because akara is not there. It will just be juho plus ti put together, juhoti. Then there are, for each of the fourth gana onwards, there are these separate pratyas, gana vikarna pratyas, the modification. The gana vikarna pratyas means that which modifies the dhatu of the gana, which modifies the anga. That is gana vikarna. Vikarna is a modification. This is divadi gana, because div is the first dhatu. Div dhatu, divadi. Divadi gana ends with akara. Akara, because ya plus a is the vikarna pratyaya. Vikarna pratyaya is ya, not yakara, ya plus a, ya. So divadi gana, div plus ya will be divya. So anga will be divya, and whether atmane pada or parasme pada, you have to add the pratyaya and just put them together. This cannot, ya cannot cause guna. So the way the dhatu is, it will remain that way, except for the ya in the anga after the dhatu. So you will get the form divyati, for example, divyati. Swadigana, su is the dhatu. Su is the first dhatu. So su plus adi is swadi. There will be a sandhi and that will become swadi. Swadigana also cannot take a guna. So swadi, su will remain su and the vikarna pratyaya is nu, which nu itself becomes no because of guna, because this nu is followed by tip and tip can also cause guna. Ting pratyas can also, depending on which kind of a pratya out of the nine, it may or may not cause guna on this sangha. Earlier we had seen, if you let's just go back there. Earlier we had seen this who. Here we had seen initially there is gachati, for example, or bhavati. If gachati we had seen, just putting it together, we are not seeing bhavati here. Bhu plus a. So bhu plus a here had become, so bhu plus a will have become, I thought I had mentioned this, I'm not able to find it. So bhu plus a will become bho, will become bho plus a, because this a is shap which can cause guna here. This guna of ukara, guna is a technical word, we'll see what guna means, but I'll just mention it right now. You will understand that guna is a change of ukara to okara, ikara to ekara. So if the dhatu had been bhi, it would have become bhe. But here the dhatu is bhu, it will become bho. So this is the influence of this akara. But this also is followed by tip. This ti, based on whether it is has a pakara or does not have a pakara, as in tip tas ji, tas does not have a pakara as it. Based on whichever pratyaya, there is a technical definition for each pratyaya, whether or not it can cause guna on this anga. Now, anga for this fellow, this pratyaya, is this entire thing, bho plus a put together, and anga for akara is just bho. Whatever precedes this pratyaya, whichever pratyaya, is the anga for that pratyaya. So anga for a is not the same as anga for t. And each pratyaya we have to analyze whether or not it can cause guna. This is a little technical, you don't need to remember all this. I am just mentioning as to how the dhatu changes forms. And what we need to know is that okara can actually be ukara in the dhatu and ekara can be ikara in the dhatu. This is how you identify a dhatu so that you can look up in the dictionary for the dhatu meaning. This is the idea of reverse engineering. So this sandhi of bho plus a is bhav. Bhav, we'll see sandhi also. And this bhav plus akara, then ti, will become bhavati. Just putting them together. Similarly, now if I add the, what we are looking at right now, this, the swadigana. Swadigana. Swadigana dhatu is su. So su is the dhatu. Su plus the vikarna pratyaya is nu. Fifth gana vikarna pratyaya. I just mentioned this for the fifth gana. Fifth gana vikarna pratyaya is nu. Then tip as usual, which we have added. Now this su, this nu cannot cause guna. We'll see why. If you can remember which gana does not take guna well and good, otherwise we have to study rules to easily remember. Now nu cannot cause guna, so it will just be sunu. The dhatu plus vikarna pratyaya will become sunu. Now when you add ti, this ti itself can cause guna to this anga. This anga is different from su. For nu the anga was su, but for ti the anga is sunu. Now sunu can, because it is ending in ukara, ukara can take guna. Ukara guna, as we have seen here, whether it is dirgha or hraswa, bhu was dirgha. And sunu is hraswa, ending in hraswa. Hraswa means short vowel, and bhu is a longer vowel, it is a dirgha. This short vowel and longer vowel, whether ukara or ukara, the guna for both is o. And ikara, ikara, for both the guna is a. So here it is u, and we have seen the guna is o, therefore this will become suno. Suno it will become, and you just put the tip together, you will get sunoti. This is the form for the third person singular. This is how you decline the word. So you will get sunoti. When you decline this fellow, Swadhigana first dhatu, you will get Sunoti. Similarly, if you go ahead and see this table, look up the table, Tudadigana is the sixth gana. Again, here the table says that whether or not it can cause guna. That is all we need to know. So, all this fourth gana, fifth gana, sixth gana, seventh gana, the dhatu will remain as it is. It is easier to identify the dhatu. No changes occur, no guna. But the pratyaya now, this nu, you can remember as nu also, or if you remember as no, then it will always become no. When the t is added, it will always become no. For you have to see in the declension table where it becomes. If you see the pattern in the declension table, then you will know when it becomes O, when it does not become O. Thereby we will know this Swadhigana, whether it will always be no or nu. Now, although it is said as nu, this in Latlakara, it will always, this pratyas, in Latlakara, you will always see the changes. Now, let's see the declension for Sudhatu. How it declines in the Latlakara Parasmi Pada, all pratyas. Just let's look at the forms. So we'll know as to why we should remember as nu, and rather where we should remember as nu and where we should remember as no, if we have to remember other lakaras also. Latlakara, just looking at the form. So Sunoti. I may have made a mistake, it may be a. Just a second. Sunoti, yeah. Sunoti. Ubhayapadi. Yeah, it's an Ubhayapadi Dhatu. Shunj. Abhishe Swadhigana. So, here, these are the forms. The Sunoti. Yeah, see, it says Shunj Abhishave is the Dhatu. In the Swadhigana is the fifth Gana. Here it says Ubhayapadi. Ubhayapadi Dhatu means it can take both kinds of pratyas. Now you see, Shunj, forget this Shunj, in the Dhatu part it will be Shunj, Mahaprana, this is not Mahaprana, Murdhanya, that Murdhanya becomes Su, it is actually Dhatu is Sun. Now Su and No, you see No here, but you see Nu here you see Nu. But in the this first column, you see all No, in the other two columns you see that Nu remains. Similarly, Atmanepada also when you add, you get Nu. All the places it will be nu. Nowhere it becomes no. Only in Parasmaipada and that too in singular. Only in Parasmaipada singular there will be guna on the pratyaya, vikarna pratyaya. The nu will become no. That's why we have to remember nu also and no also. Sunoti, sunutaha, sunvanti. Sunoshi, the no, you can see the no. And there sunutaha, sunutha remains nu. Sunomi, Sunuvaha, forget these other forms, but you just see the nu, nu remains. In the, only in singular, nu becomes no. Now that's the characteristic of knowing the, it's easier if you know the pratyas, tiptas ji, where you see pakara being there, tiptas ji, siptas tha, mipvasma, only in the singular you have pakara. Wherever pakara is there in the pratyaya, there is guna. Where pakara is not there, there is no guna. And in Atmanepada, the pratyas are ta atam jha, thas atam jham, idvahi mahin. There are no pakaras at all. Therefore, in all the cases, nu will remain nu. It will not become no. This is the difference between Parasmaipada, Atmanepada and pakara being there as it letter or not being it letter in the ting pratyas. Therefore, the form you see are sunoti and then sunoti and sunutaha, it nukar, ukara, this u at the end of the vikarna pratyaya does not take a guna. That's why it is mentioned as nu, no or nu, based on whether pakara is it or not in the pratyaya. That is Swadhigana. Similarly, these rules will apply wherever ukara or ikara is there in the end of the vikarna pratyaya or in the dhatu also. So both places we have to look at and thereby identify the form which can be the dhatu. You can do a some kind of a guesswork. Tudadigana. Tudadigana is tud. Tud is the dhatu. तुत धातु कैन नॉट टेक गुणा बिकॉज इट बिकॉज ऑफ द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ दिस प्रत्यय अ. नाउ अ इज एक्चुअली श एंड इन श ऑल्सो देर इज नो पकारा विच इज इथ. देर फोर पकारा नॉट बींग इथ एंड इट शकारा बींग इथ इट विल इट कैनॉट कॉज गुणा ऑन दिस दी धातु. सो नो यू कैन ईदर रिमेंबर द टेबल और यू कैन लुक अप द विकर्ण प्रत्यय एंड थिंक as to what is the content of the vikarna pratyaya, which is the ith letter, and whether or not it can cause guna. So if you are interested in grammar, look up the pratyayas more detail. If you can remember the chart wise which can take guna, which cannot take guna, then it's better to look up the chart. You can, if you don't remember, just look up the chart in the beginning. Over a period of time it will become second nature. So that's tudadi gana also cannot take guna on the dhatu, but this akara here, akara being the end, akara cannot take guna again. So that's another benefit to see first gana, fourth gana, sixth gana and tenth gana. 1, 4, 6, 10, this is how we remember. 1, 4, 6, 10 cannot take guna on the entire anga. The tip thing pratyayas cannot cause guna. Why? Because akara is ending. If it is an ikara ending, ukara ending, then it can take guna. If it is akara ending, this first gana, akara ending. Second gana, third gana, we don't have to bother because it will depend on the, don't have to bother as in we can't make a judgment call. We cannot make a judgment call here because the ending here will depend on the dhatu ending because akara has been elided. What will remain is the dhatu's last letter. If the dhatu has ukara or ikara, then it can take guna. If it does not have ukara, ikara, it will not take guna. This is how we have to see. But if see, akara itself can cause guna on the adadi gana or juhotyadi gana dhatu. Therefore, this tip we don't have to bother because once akara has caused guna on ikara or ukara of the dhatu in the second gana or third gana, then this it cannot undergo guna again due to tip pratyaya. This thing pratyaya, it cannot cause guna again. Therefore, only once it will cause, and that will depend on whether it is ukara ending or ikara ending here in the last letter of the dhatu in the second and third gana. Fourth gana, we have seen in the end, akara if it is there, it cannot take guna. Here yakara and akara is there, so ya is ending with akara. Therefore fourth gana also you cannot have a guna. Tip cannot, ting pratyas cannot cause guna. Similarly fifth gana, sixth gana, seventh gana, we have to analyze. Sixth gana ends with akara. Sixth gana also ends with akara, therefore no guna on the anga, but akara itself also cannot cause guna on the dhatu. Therefore tudadi gana will just remain tudati. The form will be tudati. You just put them together, tud plus akara plus tip here. When you are adding, it will become tudati. Tudadi gana will decline tudati tudataha, that no guna anywhere. Seventh gana and tenth gana also churadi gana cannot take guna. But there is a special form here. There is a difference there that the dhatu in the churadi gana needs some modification due to the pratyaya added. We'll see that. In the seventh gana is rudadi gana. This nakara, although na, which is the gana vikarna pratyaya, the special characteristics of rudadi gana is this na is not added at the end. It will come and sit in the between. It will sit after the last vowel of the dhatu. So rudh is the dhatu, rudhadi, rudh is the dhatu. The last vowel for rudh. Now when you add this, let's look at rudh. Rudh dhatu. So when you add rudh is the dhatu, when you add, the vikarna pratyaya is actually shnam, and that is the reason it is not added at the end. The content of the shnam is na. This is the vikarna pratyaya for the seventh gana. Now this nakara is not added here. It will be added after the last vowel of the dhatu, and last vowel of the dhatu is ukara. So nakara will come and sit here. Not nakara, na. Na will come and sit here. This is the specialty of the dhatu. Okay. So then you will get the form as, so the nakara being inside the between the dhatu, it will have a change in dhatu form itself, will change. So this seventh gana will be a little tricky to identify the form And after identifying the form, to reverse engineer into the dhatu is a little tricky, because the form will be this, akara will also undergo lopa, it will become rund. So the form is a little difficult. I'll just show you the form. Although the dhatu is rud, look at the forms. Just see, rud, not this, yeah, this, runadhi, the form will be runadhi. Now, from runadhi, it is difficult to go back to rud, to identify the dhatu, unless you know this nakara has become, has taken natvam, has become the murdhanya, nakara has become murdhanya nakara, nakara can become nakara. But if you can identify this na, na sitting in between, after you remove the ti, so runadhi, if I runadhi, I remove tip, then after removing tip, what remains is rund. And rund can become, we can identify what is the dhatu if we know na is a vikarna pratyaya and that is sitting in between. Pramod, did you have a question? Okay, I see that it is unmuted, so I can hear a little feedback. Okay, so that's why the form is runadhi. If we can remove the ti and we know sandhi, then you see ti has become dhi. We'll see sandhi karya and thereby how to identify this tip. If you remove, then you will get rund. Rund as the anga. And in rund, if we go through the vikarna pratyas here, the vikarna pratyas, which is it that either second gana where akara is not there. So rund plus ti, if you just add rund plus ti, rund is has no vikarna pratyaya in the end. So we know that it can be second gana, it can be third gana. Third gana it cannot be because there has to be reduplication. So it can be either second gana or no other gana is possible. So only second gana is possible, or if we know this na can come and sit in between in seventh gana, so it can be seventh gana also. So how do I identify whether it is second gana or seventh gana? How do I look up the meaning of the dhatu? So what we can do is that search in the dictionary if you find rund. But if you know rund is not a dhatu, over a period of time you'll know rund is not a dhatu. The dhatu, you'll see that nakara in this na, na is sitting in between. So if you can remove na or na, if it has become murdhanya, then you will automatically land on rud. Okay, so you automatically land on rud and thereby know that seventh gana. Or we don't need to know the gana really. Gana we need to know only when you want to decline. But if you are reading something, if you see the form runadhi, how do you identify it? By sandhi karya, you know last is dhi is ti. So you remove ti, you get runad. Runad you can't look up in the dictionary. If you look up also, you will not find runad. Therefore, na if you know, you remove na also and you will get rud. And that rud, you will find the meaning in the dictionary or dhatupata. So dhatupata rud, if you see rud, this rud will be mentioned as rudhir avarane. Avarana is the meaning. Avarana means to cover, to obstruct, to stop. So this is how we find the dhatu meaning rud. And we'll say that rudhati means he obstructs, he, she, it obstructs or blocks or covers. So these are the, this is how we identify a form, identify the dhatu, look up the meaning and land on a translation, how understanding of the word, declined word. That is the seventh gana. Eighth gana, the dhatu is tan, tanadi gana, and tanadi gana vikarna pratyaya is u. This u can become o as we saw, where pakara is it in the tip, there you will have o, where it is not, you will have u itself, it will not become o. This guna of ukara is okara. This is on the anga for ting pratyaya, but anga for o is the dhatu, and that dhatu okara ukara can cause guna. So tanadi gana, based on which is the last letter, whether it is ukara or ikara, it can take guna. So the form will be what? Tan plus u, tanu. Tanu it will become, and tanu plus ti. So when you do tanu plus ti, Tan plus U plus T. This is what the form would be, and this is for the eighth gana. tip. This will become tanu because tan is ending in a hal. Hal meaning a consonant. It is ending in a consonant and consonant cannot take guna. It has to be a vowel and only ukara or ikara which can take guna. Now when you put tan and u together, you will get tanu. Tanu plus ti, when you do tanu plus ti, because pakara is it, therefore it can cause pakara it meaning a letter which can be elided. That is the it letter. Tip, because the content is ti, which I am saying is a packaging letter. So this ti, which is pit, we will call it as pit because pakara is it. Pakara is it will be called as pit. Kakara is it will be called as kit. Not important, but I am just saying that pit, if it is pit, then it can cause guna. And this ti can cause guna on this anga, which is tan plus u. Therefore, tanu will become tano. This tanu will become tano in the next step. Tano, that is the guna. And tanoti is the form. This is how we identify. If you see tanoti as a form in when you are reading, then you remove the ti, you will get tano. Tano now, tano can or may not be a dhatu. So you have to know that most of the times when you see O, okaranta dhatus, it can be okaranta dhatu, but very rare. What you can land on is you remove this okara itself and land on tan dhatu, or you see whether it can be something else. It can become tanu because you remove the guna, you will get O, you reverse engineer, it will become tanu. And U, you know, is the U is the 8th gana vikarna pratyaya. U. So if you are looking up it as a dhatu patha, then you have to go to the 8th gana. This is the reason you have to know the which gana. But if you are looking online, you are searching, then which gana we don't really care for because all we are interested in the meaning. Nowadays it is easy. But if you have a dhatu patha book, then how do you know which gana to look for? Therefore, you have to know the gana. And tanadi gana is the 8th gana for which vikarna pratyaya is U. And thereby you land on the 8th gana and go to the 8th gana section in the dhatu patha, look up the dhatu and look up the meaning like you would look up in a dictionary. So this is how you get the form tanoti. This is the 8th gana. For 9th gana, the dhatu is kri. Kri and adi sandhi will be kriya. Kri and adi will be kriya. So it is called kriyadi gana. Kriyadi gana, the vikarna pratyaya is shnam. Shnam is na. The content is nakara. Shna, actually it is shna. Kriyadibhya shna. Shna, sorry, shna. It is shna. And then na, akara goes in some situations, so it can become just nakara. Shna, shna can become, shna the content is na. And is na, if you remove the akara, in some cases, by some technical rules, akara can undergo lopa, it can undergo elision, and what will remain is only nakara. So the forms can be na ending or na ending. So kriyadi gana. In kriyadi gana, when you add this sna, this na cannot cause any guna on the dhatu. So kri will remain kri. Kri is dirga. Kri will remain kri. But kri plus na, again kri plus na, when you add tip, this is neither a and a ending, as in nor u ending nor e ending. And we have seen that only u ending or e ending angas can take guna due to tip if it is a pith. Therefore, you just have to add them together. Kri plus na plus ti. That is how you will get the form kreenati. But there is no change at all anywhere. You just add them together. But it can become nakara in some places. That is what we have to remember. Kriyadi. Churadi gana, I was saying there is something called as vriddhi now. We have seen guna, but there is something called as vriddhi. Vriddhi is just as guna. I'll just mention here. Guna. What is guna? Guna, there are three letters of guna. Akara, okara, and there is a sutra for defining what is guna. Guna is a technical word. It is a sanya. It is a name. And a, o, and a. A, A and O. So, A and O are guna letters. Similarly, there is something called as vriddhi, vriddhi letters. Which are the vriddhi letters? Vriddhi letters are A. Instead of A, you have I, and instead of O, you have O. So, these are the vriddhi letters. Three guna letters, three vriddhi letters. So, when you say there is a guna, that means akara is already a guna. If you see akara, it will remain guna will be akar only. That's why we said that whenever in 1, 4, 6 and 10, it cannot take guna because it is already a guna letter. So there is no guna on a guna letter. Only if it is ukara or ikara, it can take ekara or okara respectively. Ikara becomes ekara, ukara becomes okara. Similarly, if akara is there, akara can become akara if there is a vruddhi ordained. Instead of guna, if vruddhi happens, ikara can become aikara and ukara can become aukara. This is the change if the vruddhi is mentioned as a rule. Vruddhi happens. Here in E, the actually it is ni, and nakara being it, ni can cause vruddhi. The content will be E only, but it will make change in the dhatu. The dhatu is chur, chur meaning to steal, and chur plus E should have become churi, but it does not become churi. This ukara here, which is the penultimate letter, the second last letter, that can take vruddhi. So this if it is the last letter, not penultimate letter, last letter can take vruddhi. Last letter, if it had been a vowel, that can take vruddhi, or the penultimate can take guna. That is the rule of the nakara being it. So either the last letter of the dhatu can take vruddhi, become a, ai or au, or the if that does not happen, if it is a consonant ending, then the penultimate will take guna. So ikara will become ekara, ukara will become okara. Here chur is ukara. So when you add chur plus churadigana chur plus e. E is actually ni. I'll just add that ni. It is nich and the content is e. This tenth gana content is e. That is what is mentioned here as e. But it is ni, and this ni can cause vruddhi in the last letter, which is the consonant, so it cannot cause a vruddhi, or guna. If it cannot cause vruddhi, it will cause guna. Then what happens is that you add this, you will get chor, because u will become o, and cho plus a e will be chor. This chor plus e will be chori, chori. So the dhatu will be chori, and chori plus ti, tip. Now this tip also can cause guna. Chori, tip also can cause guna, and the form you will see, this chori, tip, there are some more changes. This tip can cause guna, but what happens is that when you add this tip to chori, chori is a new dhatu now. Chur is not the dhatu. Chur is the dhatu in the dhatu pata. Chori is the dhatu, new dhatu after nich has been added, and you take out the dhatu of the tenth gana. You cannot use the dhatu without adding nich. So chori is the new dhatu. Now, chori will decline like the first gana. Therefore, the first gana vikarna pratyaya a will come. That's why I said that the 1, 4, 6, 10 is a anta. It has akara in the end. Although you see e as the vikarna pratyaya, the ending will always be akara, because after this chori has been added, chur dhatu has been added with ni, you will get chori. That new dhatu will decline like first gana. And that means akara will come and sit here, which is the first gana vikarna pratyaya. Therefore, the form will be chori. This ikara, again like bhu becomes bho due to guna. Guna is yes here. You will get guna. This e ending will become a guna. So chore, it will become chore. Chore plus tip. Chore plus a plus tip. And the form will be really just like bho plus a becomes bhav. A plus this a ending, chore a plus a will become pai. So you will get chora ya, chorai plus a plus tip ti, which will become chorayati. Okay, chorayati. This is the form in the 10th gana. So we have declined at least the first third person singular of all ganas. It will need a multiple practices. If you are confused, don't worry. Don't go into details if you are getting confused. Just see how to reverse engineer. Remove the. So we'll see. We'll revisit this next class and see how we can remove the tip and identify forms to reverse engineer. We'll see and how to guess the gana of the dhatu. We'll stop here. I've taken 4 or 5 minutes more because I started late. I'm sorry about that. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Any questions? Any questions, anyone? No? So we'll stop.
Okay.